I know. You know what? I forgot that that Bynum and Artest were teammates. I was gonna say, I hope so. I like training basketball players.
One thing that impressed me was your brother shows up and Nick and Nate Diaz goes, "That's our fighter."
Yeah.
That he fought for them?
He does. My brother did jiu-jitsu seminars.
With them?
Yeah. Well, he went with Royce Gracie. Yeah. And then he went, and Nick and Nate were having a jiu-jitsu seminar. So my brother would go and do and roll with them and show them, you know, how to, you know, when you have bigger opponents.
So we all know that Nick Diaz is the best boxing hands in MMA. It's a known fact. Everyone says that. How would he do against Roy Jones Jr. at this point of Roy Jones Jr. career boxing?
You're talking about the older brother, Nick.
Yep.
It's a good fight, man. Nick is he's a good boxer, I guess. You know, we'll have to see. You know, it'll probably be the first legitimate, you know, MMA fighter that really actually has boxing skills to go fight a real professional. So we'll see. You know, I don't know. How old is Roy now?
Must be in his 40s, if not older. Maybe 42, 40. How old is Roy Jones Jr.? 45? I don't want to go too high. He might be embarrassed. Like, if Hopkins is 48, 49, he must be up there too.
He's in his 40, 44.
Maybe 47,
like,
yeah.
But I'd watch it.
Your brother said Nick Diaz knocks him out in 5.
Is that what he said?
Could be.
Could be, dude. My brother used to spar with Juan Carlos Gomez. So, you know, he knows more about that shit than I do.
Have you met the new fighter from D.C.?
I have.
What's up, brother?
Who's he?
Amir Khan.
Amir Khan or Billy Dib?
Or Billy Dib, yeah.
It's Amir Dib.
Amir Dib.
These guys.
So life is good? Ready to start? Dude, waiting, man, for my Dana to show up?
Yep.
Make
Brandon
things happen?
Started Brandon today. Everybody's getting started in case we get a short call. We want to make sure that Brandon's ready to rock and roll. My Dana, hopefully this week. See what happens with Mikey. But yeah, getting all the guys getting ready to go.
How did the fans treat you in Vegas? Because Robert, Mikey, and Brandon were like rock stars. I've never seen it like that.
Yeah, it was great, man. Well, you know, the all Mexican fighter. I mean, Mexican card like that, and all those lines. What's up,
todo bien? Todo bien.
Felix.
Todo bien.
It was good. It was great, man. I mean, the crowd was unbelievable. Dude, it was packed house. Couldn't believe how many people were there.
It was a good atmosphere, good fight.
It was, man. Everybody was fun, dude. You know, Floyd's press conference was good. Everything was good, dude. I had a good time, man. This is the first time in a long time, man. Thanks, Golden Boy, for taking care of us, giving us those great seats. Richard Schaefer, man, treating us like gold.
What do you think of the press conference, the Mayweather press conference? He gave shout-outs to Brandon. He said, Brandon, minor setback versus Pacquiao, major comeback. He said, Mikey, you're a great champion. Yeah. He called Robert up to the stage.
Dude, he's a good dude, man. I mean, you know, it's like he says. He was explaining to everybody. It doesn't matter that he made it everybody wait. You know, you gotta have to wait on him. He's the big dog in boxing right now. So
he can call.
He can do whatever he wants, man.
Hey, really quick, the president of WBC told me I need to go to your fight. He said you're going to Chihuahua. By April 5th, it's in the...
Suleiman le dijo que tiene que llevarlo a Chihuahua.
They said 20,000 people will be there. It's a baseball stadium.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's a big deal.
Oh, they're playing at a baseball stadium?
Yeah. They're fighting.
Last time I went, I seen
you. I'm saying next time, you got to come. It was fun.
For Pacquiao Bradley.
All right, Pacquiao Bradley.
We're the big Russian guy fighting.
I'll be there for May and for the Mayweather and... Mayweather and Madonna fight, I'll be there. I'll be there again. Vegas like the city right now, I'll be gambling. I got used to gambling, now I'm fucking just spend all my money on gambling.
That's a bad habit.
I know, I got used to fucking gambling. Like Tony, he was dicing it up, he lost what? How much did he lose that night, Tony?
Like two.
$2,000?
Are you serious?
Three.
I think he lost.
That's nothing, we went to... What files? Marquez and Pacquiao, he lost $20,000.
No.
Yeah.
No.
That's
no
way. Stupid, man.
Yeah, you know, that's my only problem. I fucking...
Dude, that's an addiction.
$20,000. Shit, I told him, hey, man, with all that money, we could have the fucking party of our life. Spending $20,000. No one of that. Horses in the fucking hotel. Shit. Fucked up.
You gotta get something else, dude. This is
the
fucking
thing. I told you these. The last one we had was for these.
These are hard? What's up, Maniaco? How you feeling, Max? You ready to break someone? I will break you.
He died.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He died.
My
uncle.
Motherfucker. Gonna break my mouth.
Oh, this guy was just strong as fucking grip when he shakes.
Oh, I know, Mal. I don't shake his hand no more.
Why not?
Because he fucking hurts.
I got your tickets.
Where my motherfucking ticket? Where my motherfucking ticket?
Four?
Where am I?
This is the casino. Just throw. Why did I get kicked out? Okay. Well, can I have two tickets? I'll buy them though.
You buy it? Yes, you can
have it. Okay. How you feeling today, Alex?
I'm good.
A long weekend in Vegas? It was fun?
Was it too bad? Yeah, it was good. Yeah, it was a great weekend.
I didn't know you...
I liked all the flights. I loved the flights.
What did you think? Was that an early stoppage or was that legit?
I mean, he could have stopped it. He could have picked a different combination to stop it. Well, a different punch to stop it on. But, I mean, I thought for the safety of Valentino, I just thought he was just getting hit too much. Too clean. So, but, you know, I mean, it's not Canelo's fault. That's for sure. I know everybody got upset at Canelo, but it's not his fault. So, but I thought it was a good stop.
So we had Ron Artest over there. First thing he said when he saw you, he said, Alex, I want you to train me.